The Dell UltraSharp U3219Q monitor supports 4K resolutions and also has a USB Type-C port that supports both USB data DisplayPort video, as well as provides 90 watts of power to the attached laptop using USB power delivery. Today we will look at the overcurrent protection behavior of this monitor and also take a look at the differences between using a USB Type-C cable that has an e-marker versus one that has an e-marker and hence supports 5 amps of current. To run these tests, we will use the GRL-C2 test box, and we'll use that together with the PowerSuite Pro software, also from GRL. We have the GRL-C2 directly connected over Ethernet to a Dell Precision laptop where we have the software installed on. We'll go ahead and open up the software and use the default IP address to connect the software to the C2. You can see here that we've made a direct connection. On port 2, we have connected a normal USB Type-C cable without an e-marker, and on port 1, we have connected a USB Type-C cable that was provided by Dell that has an e-marker that allows the cable to support 5 amps. We'll go straight to the OCP and IV curves. And let's first look at port 2. We have connected port 2 directly to the Dell monitor using a non-EMARC cable. Once we try to get the PD source caps from the monitor, we can see that the monitor is advertising up to 3 amps on all of the 4 PDOs, which are part of the source capabilities. This is as expected. And then we can go ahead and run the OCP tests simply by clicking the play button. We'll keep the default 3 amp level where we do the current step transitions from fast to slow. You can see as the tests start running, we will first start at the 5 volts PDO. The current increases up to the 3 amp transition quickly, and then transitions to a slower ramp afterwards. And here we can see an interesting behavior where at close to 5 amps, the trigger happens. So the behavior of the Dell monitor at 5 volts is that OCP trigger protections don't happen until way after the 3 amp maximum advertised by the PDO, and OCP only triggers at 5 amps. So this may cause a problem for some devices where they may not expecting the source to be able to provide more than the max current that is advertised. So in this case, the Dell is again advertising it can provide only a max of 3 amps current, but in actuality there is no protection circuits within the Dell monitor that stops the monitor from providing a lot more than 3 amps. In this case, the monitor can provide up to 5 amps without any issues. So this could cause a problem for certain devices which is drawing power from the monitor, and they're not expecting that all that current beyond 3 amps can be pulled, thus causing a potential damage to the device if unexpected current behavior is observed and much more than 3 amps is actually pulled from the monitor. we can see that that same pattern repeats not only for the 5 volts PDO, the 9 volts PDO, as well as the 15 volts PDO. At all these three different PDOs, 5 amps is the overcurrent protection trigger point, which is above the, again, above the 3 amps max current advertised by these three PDOs. And most likely at the 20 volt level, we should see probably the same thing, where again you can see that the current is going all the way up to 5 amps without any stopping. So with the OCP test complete, we can see that even though there's good recovery between OCP events, the OCP current trigger level of 5 amps is much above the max 3 amps advertised for each of the PDOs. So now we'll go ahead and switch to port 1. We will connect the E-marked cable connected from port 1 directly to the Dell monitor. And as a comparison, we can read the source capabilities from the Dell monitor. Now here we can see that with the E-mark cable, the Dell monitor is advertising 4.5 amps on the fourth PDO, which supports 20 volts. We can go ahead again and run the OCP tests just like before. And we can go ahead and monitor where the OCP trigger event happens. We probably don't expect much differences between the previous run using the non-EMARC cable with this current run. And we expect that the OCP current trigger level to also be about 5 amps. We can see that just happened with the first PDO. Now negotiation has continued to the second PDO at 9 volts. We can just let that run. And it's getting close to 9 volts, 5 amps before triggering. And now it's gone on to the 15 volt range. So just like before, for 5 volts, 9 volts, and 15 volts, looks like the current level is going up to 5 amps before hitting the OCP trigger. So now the fourth PDO has been negotiated, and now the max current, rather than being 3 amps, that should be 4.5 amps. Let's see how the OCP trigger changes with the fourth PDO. Thank you. And here in this case, looks like the OCP level is the same, even though the max current advertised is now 4.5 amps. The current OCP trigger level goes all the way to 5 amps before triggering, just like before. Now we can take a look at the results and compare the two side by side. And here we can see that the OCP trigger levels are about the same. Doesn't matter if you use a EMARC cable or a non-EMARC cable. And most likely what's going on here is that the OCP level is basically built around the fourth PDO, the 20 volt PDO at 4.5 amps. Typically we would see OCP percentage levels over max current being about 10 to 20%. You can see with the 20 volt fourth PDO that the OCP trigger level at 5.11 amps is about 113.5%. So that's about 13.5% over the max 4.5 amps level. So looks like what happened is that Dell has decided to essentially use the same OCP current trigger level as the fourth PDO with all the other PDOs. So all PDOs, no matter what the max current is basically using the same OCP current trigger level as the fourth PDO at 20 volts, 4.5 amps. Now this might be okay for Dell PCs, which can support up to 90 watts of power, but may cause issues with devices which are not expecting a lot more than 3 amps and could potentially get some damage caused if they're not expecting so much current to be drawn from the monitor to power their device.